We need clarity. This is an accusation that to us has been addressed, of wanting to shuffle the cards, not to make well understand the difference between this house and another house. Today I claim, with my head held high, the need for clarity, to understand well that in this house there is a doctrine, in another house there is another. The other house today affirms, I make a specific quotation since today this encyclical letter is publicly distributed, in chapter 8 in paragraph 281, the leaders of that house affirm, I make a quote in his mother language. The love of God is the same for every person, whether in religion or in atheism. This is a great heresy. One plays with words, but the love of God is manifested only and only in Christ, in the Son of the living God. One cannot affirm that the love of God is the same for each person, beyond the belonging that this person lives, in the religious choice, because this means to put all religions on the same level, but not for the will of men, attributing this will to God. This is the heresy. This is deception when one speaks of brotherhood. The brotherhood for Christians is only and only in Christ. It would be more appropriate at this point to speak of concord between peoples, in order not to mix words. When we speak of brotherhood between Christians, then we can express concepts such as those of Saint Francis in a clear way, without ambiguity, but if one addresses to the whole world and one also speaks of brotherhood, the ambiguity is total, because it leads people to think that they are all sons of the same God, likewise as it has been affirmed several times in that house, but this is a heresy, because one is son only in the moment one is baptized in Christ, with Christ and for Christ. Understand the substantial and essential subtlety of this different doctrine. Here today is what we want to reaffirm with strength, and we want to return to those words that Peter exclaimed to Jesus. You are the Christ, the Son of the living God, and we want to remain anchored to those words and stand firm on that teaching, and what happens I ask, in the moment in which Peter, his successor discards Christ, that teaching, discards the Holy Spirit, what happens is what Jesus said immediately after to Peter, after having invested him with that authority, in the moment in which Peter brought a human reasoning said, Vade retro Satan. You are reasoning according to men, not according to God. The universal brotherhood, this concept that now is reaffirmed, can be pleasing to men, can be a reasoning appreciated by men, politically correct for many men, but it is not the thought of God, who called Christ, the Son of the living God, to be the one in whom to recognize the Father. And therefore in the moment in which a successor of Peter renounces Christ as the only Savior, in the moment in which he discards the cornerstone, discards the spirit that proceeds in history, places himself outside of the communion with the heart of the Father, with the heart of Christ, and he himself is no longer in a condition to receive the keys of the kingdom. Just as Jesus said to Peter, I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and all that you will bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and all that you will loosen on earth will be loosened in heaven. And well in the moment in which one discards Christ, his teaching, his spirit, no longer one has the keys of the kingdom, and no longer have the power to bind, therefore condemn and excommunicate. This the term innate in the word bind, neither loosen, then allow, absolve, in the doctrinal legal conception, that these two terms bring. So, from this reading, from this passage, we understand why the Father has wanted this church. We understand why the baby Jesus descended here in this land of love from heaven, and in an eschatological key, we understand that these words lead us to what would have happened in the moment in which the kingdom was. Now the kingdom is, New Jerusalem, land of love, land where the Father has established his dwelling. Land where there is the metaphysical dwelling of God, therefore where God has established his kingdom.